Hi everyone, my name is Vivek and welcome to my YouTube channel. This is the sixth episode to create an education website using Jar Foundation. In the previous episode, we worked on register block using the reveal component. And today, we'll add the form inside this module box. First of all, open your text editor. Click on pages and index.html. Then you can remove all of this content and instead you can add a div with a class called row and another div with a class called columns. Then we can copy this title and add them inside the S3 tag. Likewise, you can copy this content and add them inside the p tag. Now you can check your site and you should see a title and content over here. Now let's add this form. So over here you can add a form tag with a class called form. Then you can create a div with a class called row. Then we have got two columns over here, one for your name and one for email address. So you can create div class columns over here and one more div class columns. So for the form element, you can go to Foundation website, go to docs, click on site docs, click on general and forms. Then we need the input with a type text, so you can copy this label and paste it over here. We want the label called your name, so you can add your name over here, and we don't need any placeholder text, so you can simply remove it. Then you can copy this label and paste it over here. Then we need the email address. You can change the label to email address, and the input type for the email address will be email. Now we need another row for this phone and password. So just after this row, you can create a div with class called row, div class columns, and div class columns. You can copy this label, you can change it to phone, and you can change the type of input to tell. Then we need a password input type. So again, you can copy this label. You can change it to password. And the input type for password will be password. Now, let's create another row for this message. Div class row and div class columns. You can copy this label and you can change it to message, and the message box will be text area. Now let's quickly check the site and it seems everything is working good. Now let's add this input type checkbox and a button. So again, you can add a div with a class called row and another div with a class called columns. For the checkbox, let's open the Foundation website again. You can scroll down and you can copy any one checkbox. And then for label, you can copy it from our website. And for terms and condition, you can add an anchor tag. I don't have any link, so I'll just use the hash key for the time being. Then finally, let's add the register button. So again, add a div with a class called row and columns. Then you can add a button tag. The name of button is register. The type of button is button, and we need the class name called primary and button. Let's check the site now. And now it is looking exactly the same as in our design. Great. This is the end of this session. In the next session, we'll work on schedule block using table component. Feel free to comment below if you have any questions. Also, please don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to my channel to get more videos in the future. Thank you.